अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास वन, आई होप यू ऑल आर डूइंग गुड। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट यूनिट टू मॉन्स्टर्स, बट बिफोर स्टार्टिंग द यूनिट टू आई एम गोइंग टू शो यू द कवर पेज, द फ्रंट पेज ऑफ योर बुक, ऑक्सफोर्ड प्रोग्रेसिव इंग्लिश बुक। यू कैन सी इट ऑन योर स्क्रीन्स। दिस इज द कवर फ्रंट पेज ऑफ योर बुक। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट unit 2, which is on page number 8. You have to open page number 8 and we are going to start unit 2, lesson 1, listen and speak. We are going to discuss the topics parts of body, feelings, number 1 to 10, magic words, please and thank you, and then in grammar we will discuss verbs, nouns and proper nouns and adjectives as well in this unit. Okay, so today we are going to start lesson 1, listen and speak. Have you ever seen monsters? First tell me, yes or no? Oh yes, we are scared of monsters, but here the monsters in this story are very very friendly and they are very nice. Okay, so let's start doing exercise A. Complete the dialogues using the words in the box, and the words are given in the box: book, here, please, thank you. Okay, you can see the picture. There's a pink monster standing here and the boy who is sitting on a yellow couch who is reading a book. Okay, and you can see the three rectangular, blue rectangular kind of things, boxes. These are called speech bubbles. Okay, these rectangular, blue rectangular boxes are called speech bubbles. And speech bubble is used when someone is saying something. When someone says something, we put that sentence in this speech bubble to show its importance and to show that someone is saying something. Okay, so like this, the first speech bubble is pointing towards this pink monster. So it means that this monster is saying something. He's saying that dash, give me a dash. So when do you ask something, you always say please, right? We always say please. So you have to write here please with capital P, because whenever we start a sentence, we start it with a capital letter. So write P, capital P, L E A S E, please. Okay, so write please, give me a book. This word book, B double O K, B is with small b. Okay, so we are writing P, capital P here, we are, because we are starting a new sentence. Okay, please give me a book, full stop. At the end we always end the sentence or a simple sentence with a full stop. Okay, and we end the asking sentence or question sentence with a question mark. Okay, we put a question mark at the end of a question sentence, and for a simple sentence we always put a full stop. Okay, so what the pink monster is saying, please give me a book, full stop. And what is the boy saying, dash, you are. So this speech bubble is pointing towards this boy, so that's why the boy is saying here you are. So you have to write H E R E here. Okay, on this place you write here, H capital H E R E here. The boy is saying here you are, monster, here you go. And the monster is saying in return, after getting the book, the monster is happy, is feeling happy. So the monster is saying thank you. So you have to write this word thank you and start writing with capital T again, T H A N K, thank, give a space, and then write small y y o u, thank you. Okay, the monster is saying thank you. So have you noticed two magic words here? They have been used by a monster, please and thank you. Okay, so do you say please and thank you when you demand something and when that demand is accomplished, or when you say something or your parents give it to you, do you say thank you in return? Yes, we all do that, or we all say that. Okay, now use these words to talk with your friend or your family member. Example, please give me a pen. Here you are. Thank you. You can say, please give me a glass of water. And the other person will say, hey, here you are. And you will say, thank you in return. Okay. So exercise B is act out these words. The words are given in the box. These are our feelings. What do we feel? We feel angry. We feel happy. So the first word is angry, A-N-G-R-Y, angry. The second word is happy. The third word is sad. The fourth word is sleepy. The fifth word is afraid. The sixth word is thirsty. And the last word is hungry. Okay, when we are angry, okay, someone has broken my toy. I am very angry. That means I am in anger. I am not feeling happy. I am angry. I am in anger. So you get angry when something happens against your thought or against your demands. Okay. So the second word is happy. When you feel happy, I feel happy when I play with my cousin, or I feel happy when I eat an ice cream. Third word is sad. When do you feel sad? I feel sad when I get sick. Okay, tell me when you feel sad. Sleepy. When do you feel sleepy? I feel sleepy when I cannot concentrate. When I cannot concentrate, that means I am feeling sleepy. The next word is afraid. What is the meaning of afraid? Afraid means to get scared. Are you scared or afraid of monsters? Yes, we all are afraid of monsters or wild animals, right? We can also say that I am afraid of dark. The next word is thirsty. When you feel thirsty, yes, we all feel thirsty when we do not drink water. So we can say that I want to drink a glass of water because I am feeling thirsty. And the last word is hungry. When you feel hungry, I am feeling hungry after looking at the yummy burger. Or I want to eat food because I am very hungry or I'm feeling hungry. So you can use these all words in your sentences. This is an oral exercise only, okay? Or the next thing is very interesting. This is exercise C. That is, listen to your teacher, write a number beside each word in exercise B. So write number one here for angry. Number one beside angry. Number two for happy. Write number three for sad. Number four for sleepy, write number five besides afraid. Number five and number six here besides thirsty, and number seven besides hungry. So these are seven words. You can read them again. It's angry. You can make an angry face. Happy, make a happy face. Sad, make a sad face. Sleepy, make a sleepy face and yawn. Afraid, make a face that shows that you are afraid. Thirsty, make a face that you feeling thirsty. And hungry, touch your tummy and feel that you are hungry. Okay. Exercise D, sing this song, 10 in the bed. Oh my God, look at them. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 10. The 10 girls are sleeping on the bed, on the same bed. Oh my God, is it possible? What do you think? Let's sing this song. There are 10 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. There are 9 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. Open your all 10 fingers, and as I am singing the poem, you have to close your finger when the one girl falls out. Okay. Open your 10 fingers. There are 10 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. So here you have to close your one finger, and the 9 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. And how many fingers are left? 8 fingers are left. So there are 8 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. And how many are left? 7. So there are 7 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. There are, how many are left? 6. There are 6 in the bed, and the little one says, roll over, roll over. So they all roll over and one falls out. And how many are left? 5 girls are left on the bed. So similarly, you have to sing this poem and you have to close your fingers until the last girl remains on the bed. Okay? Okay, Jean, we are moving towards the next exercise, which is exercise A on page number 9. It's lesson 2, unit 2, lesson 2, phonics and words on page number 9. Let's read it. Read the words with the ER and Y sounds. Match the pictures to the words. So the pictures are given here. The words are here with ER. Words are here. R words are here. And E words are here. Happy, happy. Y sounds E here. Even it comes in the end, it gives you a long E sound. Okay. So what is the first word with ER? Flower. Say the word with me. Flower. Flower. And you have to use the orange color and match the flower with this word flower. Monster. Monster. ER word. Monster. Water. Sister. Brother, mother, father. So these all are ER words, list of ER words. Say it again with me. Flower, monster, water, sister, brother, mother, father. Okay, so match the father with red color, match the mother with this picture with green color, match, use the yellow color to match the word brother with this picture brother, and use the blue color with to match sister with the picture sister, and the pink color to use pink color to match the monster with the picture monster. Okay, so you have to use these colors to match them, the words with the picture. These are ER words. Say them again and again, and you can also learn the spellings of these words as well. Okay, so now we are going towards the other list of words, which are Y words, E words. Y is coming in the end and it's giving you E sound. Happy. Say it with me. Happy. Angry. Make the faces as well. Happy. Smile. Happy. Angry. Who is angry? This one man is angry here. This picture is angry. Sleepy. This one is sleepy. Hungry. Hungry. This one is hungry. This picture is hungry. It shows that he's very hungry. He's taking out and licking his lips. Daddy. Daddy. Where's the daddy? This is the daddy. Daddy. Mommy. Where's mommy? This is mommy. And this is daddy. So you have to match this word mommy with this mommy, and mother as well with this mother, because if this is mother, this is mommy as well. Okay. And daddy, you have to match daddy with this dad with using red color, and you have to use the same color to match his father to this, to the picture father. Okay, so the word again is happy, angry, sleepy, hungry, daddy, mommy, and daddy. So where is the picture hungry? This is the picture. You have to match this picture with this word. Hungry. Sleepy is already done for you. Angry. Which picture is angry? This is this one. And happy. This is a happy face. Okay. Okay, ji. Next exercise B is game. Listen to the sounds. Put up your hand, and if you hear the ER sound, okay, and nod your head if you hear the Y sound. So you can play this game with your family members. They will say these ER words and Y words. You can play it with your mother or father, and you can play a sit stand game. You can play hands up game. Like you can put your hands up for ER word, and nod means that you have to say your word. You have to move your head in when you say yes. So you have to move your head in yes when you say yes. So move that word, your head upside down. And then you have to play this game with your family members, okay? And you will enjoy this game. Exercise C, complete the words using ER or Y. So here the first picture is given here, and the first sentence is Fiza's brother is sleepy, or Fiza's brody is sleeper. What is the correct answer? What you will do, what you will write? ER here for brother, you will write ER, or you will write I. Why? You will write ER. Fiza's brother is sleepy or sleeper? Yes, Fiza's brother is sleepy. You will write Y here, okay? In the first blank, you will write ER. In the second blank, you will write Y. Number two, look at the second picture for the sentence. The monster is angry, or the monster is angerer. What you will do? The monster. So for the monster, you have to write M-O-N-S-T-E-R. Monster is angry. You can see the monster's face. It's angry, A-N-G-R. So you only have to write Y, angry. Number three, look at this. The picture, mommy is happy, or the mummer is happier. What you will do? M-U-M-M-E-R or M-U-M-M-Y? Yes, M-U-M-M-Y. Mummy is H-A-P-P-Y, happy. Mummy is happy. Number four, Teddy is drinking water, or Tedder is drinking water. What you will write? You will write T-E-D-D-Y, Teddy. You will write Y, Teddy is drinking water. You can see Daddy is drinking water. So you will write ER here, water, W-A-T-E-R, water, okay? So I'm going to repeat the sentences for you again. Fiza's brother, you will write ER here, is sleepy. Why sleepy? You have to write Y here, but because we cannot write sleeper, okay? The monster is angry. So ER here, monster, and Y here, angry, because we cannot write monster is angerer, okay? So you have to write monster is angry. Number three, mummy or mummer, what is the right word? Mummy, of course. So write Y, mummy is happy. Y, happy. And write Teddy, Y for Teddy, write Y, Teddy is drinking water, ER for water, ER is missing here, okay? Okay, next exercise D is very interesting. This cat is just like a Tom cat, right? I like Tom and Jerry. Do you like Tom and Jerry? I like watching them. This cat looks like a Tom. And you have to label the pictures with the words in the box. And the words in the box are ear, ear, E-A-R, ear, mouth. This is the ear. And this is the mouth, M-O-U-T-H. Say the words with me, mouth. And tail, T-A-I-L, tail. Wing, W-I-N-G, wing. E-Y-E-I, E-Y-E-I, leg. L-E-G, leg. This is an eye, and this is the leg. Okay, so let's do it. You have to write for this. What is this? This is an ear, E-A-R, ear. So you have to write ear here, ear. The mouth is already done for you. So what is this? This is an eye. So you have to write E-Y-E-I. And this one is a leg, L-E-G, leg. And this one is a tail of the cat. T A I L, tail. So you have to write tail. Here it's a tail again of the parrot. Tail, T A I L, tail. E Y E I. This is the wing of the parrot. W I N G, wing. W I N G, right wing here. And this is the leg. L E G, leg. Okay. Okay, the next, on the next page, we have very interesting story, lesson 3, The Hungry Monster. We are going to read it and we will enjoy the story with the pictures. Okay, the illustrations are very interesting as well. So listen as you read the story, then answer the question. And what is the question? Is the monster good or bad? So we'll discuss this question in the last, but let's start the story. This is Mango Django. Mango Django is written with the capital M and with capital J. It means it's a proper noun. And what are proper nouns? Proper nouns are names that are very special. So we write them with the capital letter. Your name is also a proper noun. You always write your name with the capital letter. And similarly, very important places like Pakistan, Lahore, and important important things like Holy Quran, we write them with capital letter as well. So this is the Mango Django. He's a monster. Oh my God, he's a monster. He has red ears. Can you see his ears? Red ears and green wings. He's so colorful. He has green wings like a parrot, and he has red ears like wings of butterfly, and he has a long blue tail and 6 legs. This long blue tail is just like crocodile's tail, but it should be red, green, but it is blue, and it has 6 legs as well. So this is Mango Django. He's a monster. He has red ears and green wings. He has a long blue tail and 6 legs. Long blue is an adjective. Long is an adjective. Blue is an adjective. Adjective. And what is an adjective? Adjective tells you about the noun. And what is a noun? Noun is a naming word. Noun is a naming word. So just remember it. Say it again and again. Noun is a naming word. And what is a verb? Verb is a doing word. Verb is a doing word. Verb is a doing word. So you have to repeat this again and again. Okay. Noun is a naming word. Verb is a doing word. Okay. And this is Mango Django. Okay, look at the next picture. The children are sitting in the living room. They are watching TV, and the Mango Django is coming inside the room. Here are Sarah. This is Sarah. She is wearing green shirt and blue trousers. And Ali, who is sitting on the sofa, he is wearing pink or red t-shirt and black trousers. And this is Fizza. Fizza is wearing a yellow dress. Sara and Fizza.